Hello viewers, welcome to this video lecture series on computer network. Any type of numerical on IP addressing can be solved easily if you remember the contents in this table. The details about classful addressing I have explained in detail in one of my previous video session. Here I am just going to put it in a summary form. You can always check that class A address, if you are writing it in a binary, the first bit will be 0. And for class B it will start with 10, for class C it will start with 110. Only the starting bits I am telling, okay, out of 32 bits, the starting bits, if it is 0, it is class A, if it is 10, it is class B, if it is 110, it is class B, class C. And if you are writing in dotted decimal notation, you are writing it in terms of 4 bytes. So if you want to find out to which particular class a given IP address belongs to, just check the first byte. The range for the first byte is mentioned here. By observing the first byte, you can decide. So if the byte falls within this range, if the first byte falls within the range of 0 to 127, it is class A, 128 to 191, it is class B, and 192 to 223, it is class C. And also you can remember easily with these 4 letters. For class A, you write NHHH. That means the first byte is indicating the network portion. And for the network portion, you should always write in binary all the bits as ones. Once you write down all the bits as ones, the equivalent decimal value is 255. So you are writing here N, okay? That means the N is indicating network portion, and that is what, 255. And this portion, whatever you are writing here, comes under the default mask or subnet mask. So this default mask will always give you information about what it will say, how many bits are for the network portion and how many bits are for the host portion. So out of 32 bits, 8 bits are denoting what, the network portion, and 24 bits are denoting the host portion. So that network portion bits you are writing in decimal, 255, and the host portion in decimal it becomes 000. This way you can relate these two columns. Now for the class B, NNHH. That means first two bytes are the network portion. So if you write first two bytes in decimal, it will become 255 255, because network portion it should be all ones. So you are writing 255 255.0.0. For class C, first three bytes are denoting the network portion. So you will be having all ones in the first three bytes, that is 24 bits are ones. And when you convert that into decimal, 255.255.255, and the last bit will be what, 0, which is the host portion. So this way, this I'll write down the column numbers here, 1 2 3 4 5. The fifth column is giving you the information about the network portion and the host portion of class A, class B and class C. And from that you can extract how many possible networks and how many possible hosts are there. Now once we know that, suppose if you take class A only, 255.0.0.0, we know that the first 8 bits are denoting the network portion and the last 24 bits are denoting the host portion. First 8 bits which are all ones, 2 to the power of 8, which is equal to 256. But these are what, networks. What are these? These are the possible networks. But when you are forming the networks, actual networks will be 2 to the power of 7, not 2 to the power of 8. Why we are subtracting is because in this 8 bits which are used to denote the network portion, out of that 8 bits, look at this first column. The first bit is denoting always to which class the IP address belongs to. So from that 32 bits, the first bit is always denoting to which class that particular IP address belongs to. And the first bit is what? It is a part of the first byte. The first byte is having a value all ones. Now you have to remove from that 8 bits, you subtract 1. So you will be having what, 2 to the power of 8 minus 1, 2 to the power of 7, 128 networks are possible. How many? 128. So that is why you can check here, I have written first possible networks 2 to the power of 8, because 8 bits are used to denote the network part. But actually you have to subtract 1, because 1 bit is indicating to which class that particular IP address belongs to. That if you subtract, you will get 128. So this is how you can always relate these two, okay, columns. These two column information, these are the possible networks and these are the actual networks. In numericals, if it is asked networks, you can only go for what, the possible networks. If it is asked actual networks, then you can write down 128. Similarly, when you look into the host part is 24 bits. All 24 bits should be zeros, and 2 to the power of 24, 1 crore 67. Here there should be one more number. 1677716. Here also I'll write down 1677214. Okay, similarly for the possible host you can check 2 to the power of 24 is how many hosts are possible. 1,67,77,216 hosts are possible. Possible hosts are definitely because 24 bits are used to denote the host ID. But in that, once you get this value, you have to remove two IP addresses. Minus two you need to do. So it will be 1,67,77,214. Now these two addresses, why we are removing is always in that IP addresses, if suppose 1,67,77,216 addresses are possible in a network, always remember the first address is given to the network only. So the first address is removed and the last address is called as the broadcast address. So these two addresses you should not assign to any host. For that reason, whatever are the possible host, from that you should subtract 2. So this is how I have shown here. Now you will get 1,67,77,214. So this way you have to understand the contents that are there in this table. Now coming to B, as I said, 16 bits are used to denote the network portion. So 2 to the power of 16, 65,536 networks are possible. But once again, actual networks will be what you have to write, not 2 to the power of 16, but 2 to the power of 14, because this 2 bits, 1, 0 are indicating the class. That's why you will form actually only 16,384 networks. Possible are 65536. But actual networks are 16384. And similarly, number of hosts, how many you can check here, HH00, that means 16 bits are used to denote the host part. 65,536 hosts are possible, but you have to remove two IP addresses from that. So possible IP address, see here I'm writing possible host, you can write down possible IP addresses also, fine. Usable host, only usable IP addresses. So now when you write here 2 to the power of 16, 65,536 hosts are possible, but in that 2 you need to subtract. First and last address cannot be given to any host. So 65,534 actual IP addresses or actual connections can be given. Next is for the class C, the first 24 bits are denoting the network portion. So in the default mask you can check 255.255.255.0. So 24 bits are denoting the network portion. 2 to the power of 24, these many networks are possible, but actual networks from this 24 you are subtracting 3, so it will become 2 to the power of 21 and the actual networks will be 2097152. Host bits are only 8 in the class C, so 256 addresses are possible in each network, and out of 256 addresses, 2 addresses you cannot give it to host, so it will become 254. So this way the contents of classful addressing I have summarized in a form of a table. And when you are writing here the network portion, remember, see, suppose if I am taking one IP address 192.168.16.0, so you can check that this 192 belongs to what class C range, so it is a class C IP address. And in class C IP address, 24 bits are denoting the network part. So this much is denoting the network part. Whereas the last 1 byte, 8 bits are denoting the host part. So this 8 bits, whatever you are writing, okay, how many hosts are possible? 2 to the power of 8, 256 IP addresses are possible in class C. And 256 IP addresses in which network? 24 bits are there. So 2 to the power of 24 is 16777216. Fine, these many networks are there, fine. And in these many networks, for each of this network, in each network you can have 256 IP addresses. So this is how you have to understand, even for class A, class B, class C. For example, if you take class A, number of networks are possible, networks are 256. In each of the network, these many hosts, 2 to the power of 24 hosts are possible. Similarly, in class B, 65,536 networks are possible, and in each network, 65,536 host or 65,536 IP addresses are there. And here you can check for class C, 2^24 networks are possible, and in each network, 256 IP addresses are possible. So now, why this was the complete information about the classful addressing, but this information holds good even to understand the concepts of classless addressing also. And if you find this information useful, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye bye and take care.